The border to Austria. No control. The only important thing here was to buy a toll sticker. Vienna calling. Unfortunately, the hotel was in the middle of the city, so the Land Cruiser had to spend the nights 5 kilometers away on a park and ride parking lot. A tour through the city, to the Hofburg, the Burgtheater and the Stephansdom. Well, then instead of a kangaroo steak, a fancy Wiener Schnitzel. I went on to the Anchor Clock, the Belvedere Castle and the Hundertwasserhaus. And finally into the Ferris wheel on the Prater. The next day to Schönbrunn Palace. Then on to Salzburg. A great view from the fortress Hohen Salzburg over the city. The Mirabelle Garden, the garden of the Mirabelle Palace, was already in hibernation, but the Cathedral Quarter offered a good alternative. Evening atmosphere on the Salzach. This was certainly home to another craft in former times. An idea for train stations or chronically loss-making small airports. A short stop in Zell am See, but here too, the season is over. Remembrance of the victims of the Glacier railway accident in Kaprun 18 years ago. Also at Innsbruck already a strong Christmas mood, but Rudolf is still resting a little. Once again on the main road over a small pass, and I'm back in Germany. It was a little strange feeling. Garmisch-Partenkirchen greets me with bad weather. But the next day I had bright sunshine on the Zugspitze. With almost 3000 meters the highest mountain of the Wettersteig Mountains. And across the mountaintop runs the border between Austria and Germany. Towards Munich it was then completely over with reasonable good weather. A short visit to the Olympic site and the Frauenkirche. Then it was time to warm up inside. The Land Cruiser is still Australian, but at least there was an environmental badge from the German TÜV for entrance to the German city centers. Shortly before Rothenburg ob der Tauber the hint, Frankfurt only 196 kilometers. Rothenburg ob der Tauber. Google Maps led me across the city center to my hotel. Sometimes that was precision work. Also in Rothenburg was pre-Christmas time. In the morning of the last day, unfortunately again cloudy and rain, but no matter, finish.
In 400 meters, keep left at the fork. Follow signs for Basel, Darmstadt. Left at the fork. Change 26 Darmstadter Krebs, use the right lane to follow signs for A672 toward Darmstadt, then keep right at the fork.
After 234 days at home again. The saying in the hotel in Garmisch I found actually quite fitting. And no matter whether Franz Kafka said it, or Friedrich Nietzsche, or the Spanish poet Antonio Machado. It's possible to drive a car from Australia to Germany. Apart from the route across the Pacific, of course. Two weeks later, as promised when I said goodbye at the end of January, I stopped by my former colleagues shortly before Christmas. It was a great get-together. What remains? Certainly great adventures, memories and experiences. And what comes next? Well, let's see, maybe the crossing of the Atacama Desert? But only if my son comes along with me and takes such great drone shots again.